my goodness, what a play. Michael Jordan took it down.
What's going on, everybody? I'm back with another video. This one is a very special video. Back with a video that showing tribute to the 1983-84 University of San Diego basketball team, the first team to make it to the NCAA tournament. Man, I definitely wanted to do a shoe showing respects to my teammates. A lot of them really embraced me. Coming from Michigan to California to San Diego to a Catholic university, it was very, very different for me. But these guys here were some amazing teammates, and we went on a dream run and made it to the NCAA tournament. Before I get into this, I want to give a moment of silence for a teammate who has passed away, and then we'll get into the review of the sneaker. Thank you. It is Mike Whitmarsh, number 32. I tell you, he was an honorable mention All-American. He was the backbone of our team. He was the one who went to Coach Bravelli and said, let's do the Whit to Bostic alley-oop. That was pretty much every game where we had that play going, where I went back door, he threw it up there anywhere near the rim, and I got it. There's some video footage of it. Shout out to Trippy Main Jim. He created this Torero's New School jersey. Has my name on the back, where our original jerseys did not have our names on the back. And I tell you, the colors just are the true University of San Diego colors. So I'm going to rock this throughout the video. Once again, shout out to Trippy Main Jim on Instagram for that. He also, if you saw my shattered backboards, he sent me a jersey to rock with those that MJ rocked in that game overseas where he shattered the backboard. So the shattered backboard ones. All right. Before we get into it, I want to give a big shout out to some others that took part in this custom. D-Nice Customs. They did the Toreros, University of San Diego, laser engraving, and the Bostic 24. The logos that are on the shoe as well. Also, they did the custom insoles that are leather with the Roughneck and Jumpmanbostic logos in there. Standout socks with the long and the mid in the socks to match the shoes. Lace Lab. Shout out to them. They did the 3M lacing for the shoe. Here is the creator of the shoe, AstroTurf Customs. There's his information on where to reach him at. And I appreciate you for taking the time to make this custom right here happen. Let's jump into it. On the left shoe, we had a starting five, which is myself, Mike Whitmarsh, number 32. If you don't know about him, please Google him. He was on the inaugural beach volleyball Olympic team where they took the silver medal. He was an honorable mention All-American 1984 on the USD basketball team, drafted by the Portland Trailblazers He was released by them, picked up by the Minnesota Timberwolves, and narrowly missed that team. Played overseas for a few years, and then he took up playing beach volleyball, where he was a star on the beach volleyball circuit. And he tragically passed away on February the 17th, ironically, 2009. So rest in peace, Whit Daddy. That's what we used to call him, because he was a beast on the court, man. That guy was an ultimate teammate. And like I said, he went to Coach Pavelli, who was the head coach, and said, let's put in this play for Bostic, a lob play. And nine times out of 10, that boy, it worked, the lob. All right. We have Whit Marsh, Scott Thompson, Anthony Rolls Royce. We called him Rolls Royce because he was like, he was just smooth, left-handed, had game. Chris Carr, my roommate, number 10, the point guard. I was the two guard. We were the backcourt. Eric Musselman, Randy Brickley. I tell you, Randy Brickley was underrated. This guy, he could, man, you better not leave him open. He just didn't have a chance to show his skills while I was there, but he was the ultimate teammate, very supportive, and one of the cool guys to hang out with, most definitely. John Prunty, he was like the rock. He was a four-year starter, point guard, very knowledgeable, gave a lot of information on the teams and the teams in the conference. He was just like a coach on the floor. Bill Penfold, two guard, really gave me a lot of information on a lot of the players and teams that we would play against, and the ultimate teammate. Mario Coronado, small forward, or power forward, I'm sorry. Steve Krawman, center, power forward. Dave McIver, power forward. Joe Fish, center. Nils Madden, power forward. El Moscatel, another left-hander that was a long-range bomber. Coach Pavelli, Coach Constantino, who recruited me out of junior college in Arizona, along with Coach Dave Babcock. Coach McGee, former player at USD, holds a lot of records at the school, mainly in rebounding. He was a beast back in his day there. Here are some of my accomplishments on the left shoe. 11.1 points per game, honorable mention all conference, best defensive player on the team. And here are our team accomplishments, 83-84 West Coast Athletic Conference champions. They've since changed the name. First USD Conference Championship team, 1984 NCAA tournament, where we played Princeton. And had we beat Princeton, we would have went and played UNLV. Could you imagine that? But it didn't happen. But AstroTurf, man, I tell you, you killed these, bro. I really, really like them. The logo on the tongue with the Torero. A lot of details in this shoe. 3M lacing, like I stated on there. Just how the fade between the baby blue and the navy blue, everything that went into it, definitely a dope, dope sneaker. The laser engravings. A
like that chrome shining. I'm glad that was left there. That's really dope with these laces. Super cool. Shout out to Lace Lab, Standout Socks, D-Nice Customs, Tippy Main Gym, and also the actual creator of the shoe, AstroTurf Customs. Thank you. Thank you all for making this custom shoe a reality for me as I show tribute and respects to my teammates and coaches from the 1983-84 West Coast Athletic Conference Champions, University of San Diego Toreros. I couldn't even imagine trying to fit into these now. Size 36. Wow. And after that year, 1985-86, I was on the card that had our schedule on it. So you know what it's time to do now? Take these boys straight to the foot game. Morning word. A leader is one who knows the way, goes the way, and shows the way. It's your main man, Jumpmanbostic, fading to the back from the basement of the J's. Make sure you hit that subscription button. Make sure you click that bell so you don't miss anything I'm bringing to you. Lots more content coming your way. Holler at you soon. Peace.